Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
Good afternoon, all.
My name is Fiona and I have the pleasure of conducting our ceremony today. I'd like to introduce my colleague, Jacqueline, who is the registrar, and she will ensure that all the legal requirements are met and fulfilled. So we will be starting our ceremony in just a few moments. Before we do so, can I ask you all to just check your mobile phones, make sure they're switched off or switched on to silent, and that they won't ring throughout the duration of the ceremony. As you can see, we do have our professional photographer to record this event, so I could have asked that you put your phones away and just enjoy the ceremony with them. So I think that Corey is probably quite keen now to get proceedings underway.
Yes.
So can I ask all who are able to please be upstanding to welcome your bridal party. Ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, may I extend a very warm welcome to you all to St. Pierre Hotel and a very special welcome to our bride and our groom. Would our guests please be seated? On behalf of Corey and Jodie, I should like to thank you all for coming here today to share in this their wedding ceremony. This place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages, and the ceremony that you're about to hear has been especially chosen by our couple. So I should now like to ask you both to please confirm your full names.
Corey Manship Rees.
Thank you.
Jodie Ann Price.
Thank you very much. We are all here today to witness the marriage between Corey and Jodie. However, if there is any person here present who knows of any lawful impediment to this marriage, then he or she should declare it now. It's a good start, I guess,
yeah,
isn't it?
Good.
Before you're joined in matrimony, it's my duty to remind you both of the solemn and binding character of the vows that you're about to make. Marriage in this country means a union of two people, voluntarily entered into for life and to the exclusion of all others. I'm now going to ask you both a question, and if in agreement, I should like you to respond with, I will. Corey, will you promise to love and cherish Jodie, whatever the future may bring?
I will.
Thank you. And Jodie, will you promise to love and cherish Corey, whatever the future may bring?
I will.
Thank you both. Marriage joins two people who trust the love that they have found. It is a partnership in which each can grow and develop. It's a statement to those around them that they found in each other such love and support that they wish to share the rest of their lives together. Corey and Jodie have found in each other happiness, fulfillment, and love. As a consequence of this love, they now wish to affirm their relationship and offer to each other the security that comes from legally binding vows, sincerely made and faithfully kept. So we now come to the first of our legal words today. I'm going to ask you both to declare that you are legally free to marry. So Corey, please repeat after me.
Okay.
I declare that I know.
I declare that I know.
Of no legal reason.
No. That no legal reason.
Why I, Corey Manship Rees. May not be joined in marriage. To Jodie Ann Price. Thank you very much. Okay, Jodie. I declare that I know. Of no legal reason. Why I, Jodie Ann Price. May not be joined in marriage. To Corey Manship Rees. Thank you both. Marriage is the joining of two people who share the promises only marriage can make, to share the sunshine and the shadows, and to experience a richer and more fulfilling life because of this. In marriage, we give ourselves freely into the hands of the one we love, and in doing so, each of us receives the love and trust of the other as our most special gift. Would you like to turn to face each other before your vows, please? Corey and Jodie, we celebrate with you today. We are glad to join with you in the solemnisation of your marriage, to witness your vows and support you in your intentions for your future life together. Our couple are now going to make their chosen promises to one another. So Corey, please repeat after me. Jodie, I promise. To cherish and care for you. Whatever the future may bring. Thank you. And Jodie, if you can repeat after me as well, please.
Corey, I promise.
To cherish and care for you.
Whatever the future may bring.
Thank you. When you look at each other, you see all the hope and promise of your life together as the love that was always there grows stronger still. You will see that you've learned what it takes to make a relationship work. What you have between you is special, and together as a married couple, this will only grow. So can I please ask all our guests to stand for the contracting words? So our couple have chosen a very short ceremony today. And Corey and Jodie, as you repeat the words of the legally binding vows, you will become husband and wife. So Corey, please repeat after me.
I, Corey Manship Rees. Take you, Jodie Ann Price.
To be my wedded wife.
Thank
you. And Jodie, if you can repeat after me as well. Take you, Corey Manship Rees. To be my wedded husband. Thank you both. So we now come to the exchange of rings, which is the traditional way of sealing the contract you've just made. The wedding ring is an unbroken circle. It has no beginning and no end, and it symbolises unending and everlasting love. So Jordan, if you could step forward with the rings, please. And if you could pass Jodie's ring to Corey first. Okay. So if you can take your wife's ring and slide it halfway down the finger, hold it in position and then repeat after me. I give you this ring. As a token of my love and affection. Lovely. And slide it all the way down.
Jesus.
Lovely. And if you can pass Corey's ring to Jodie, please. Okay, Jodie, if you just slide your husband's ring halfway down the finger and then just hold it in position.
I give you this ring.
As a token of my love and affection. Lovely, and slide it all the way down.
Didn't do much better, did I?
You're doing great. So our guests, be seated again, please. This is a new beginning for you both. May you have many happy years together, and may all your hopes and dreams be fulfilled. May you believe in each other, and may the warmth of your love enrich not only your lives, but also the lives of all those around you. Corey and Jodie, you've both made the declarations prescribed by law, and you've made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your witnesses, your family, and your friends. And so I'm very pleased to confirm that you are husband and wife. Congratulations! I must say, you both agreed, I could say congratulations, you may kiss the bride. That was the shortest kiss ever. So should we do another kiss? Congratulations. Well done, both.
Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you.
So, ladies and gentlemen, our couple are now going to sign their marriage schedule. If I could just ask you not to take any photographs for a few moments longer, thank you.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ.
Words are out.
Okay, we'll wait for your music to stop now, and I've got a few words to say.
This song's literally just started, so I don't know if you want to tell them to end it.
I don't know if you can see me.
I'm trying not to.
God, I'm standing on me.
What are we doing?
Waiting.
For what?
The music to end.
Oh,
so
right.
She can say things and then we
do. Oh, right, okay.
Okay, so I've got a few words to say and then we'll introduce you to everybody as Mr. and Mrs. Manship Reese then, okay?
Okay.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to keep you much longer. It really is a beautiful day, and I'm sure everyone's going to have the most amazing time celebrating here at St. Pierre. My final duty is also an incredible pleasure. That's to wish you both a very long and happy married life together. I would like to end our ceremony with the words of an old Celtic blessing, which is wishing you both a house full of sunshine, hearts full of cheer, and a love that grows deeper each day of the year. So, ladies and gentlemen, can I please ask you all to be upstanding? And join with me in a round of applause as we congratulate, for the very first time, the new Mr. and Mrs. Manship Reese.